One of the key features of Field Security Plus is the ability to set mandatory fields on master data. Field Security Plus also introduces the ability to automatically block the record until such time as all mandatory fields have been filled out. So let's take a look at how easy it is to set up mandatory fields on master data. I'm going to navigate through to the Field Security Setup page, and from here I can navigate through to the tables. This is showing me a list of all Business Central tables, where I have the ability to choose the table and set mandatory fields based at the table level. I have an option to filter this list further, and in this instance, I've chosen to just show tables where mandatory fields have been specified. And in my example, it's just the customer table that I've used in order to demonstrate the mandatory fields functionality. From here, I can drill down onto the three fields. This is now showing me specifically the customer table and all the fields that I can select as being mandatory. I can filter this list further by only showing the mandatory fields that have already been selected. So these are fields that I've pre-populated for this example. Up at the top, we've got mandatory options, and the first one is the trigger option. Here we have three values: all changes, when the record is modified, or when a record is inserted. I have the ability to block the workflow on warning. So what this will do is prevent the user from invoking a customer workflow, if it is enabled, from being sent to the approver until such time as the mandatory field requirement has been met. The other useful feature of Field Security Plus is the ability to automatically block the record until such time as that mandatory requirement has been met. So in this instance, I've selected the block field, and the value I want to set it to is all. And this will be initialized against that customer until such time as those mandatory field requirements have been met. But let's take a look at this in action from the customer. I'm going to navigate through to the customer list, and from here I'm going to create a new customer. The user is now shown a list of customer templates available to assist in initializing the customer with default values, and I'm going to select the first one to initialize my customer. Immediately when the customer card is displayed, the user is notified of the fields that are mandatory. So I'm going to go ahead and populate the name, which is one of the mandatory fields. What you'll now notice is that the warnings up the top have been reduced to just the phone number and the salesperson code. And the other thing that's occurred is that the customer has been set to a blocked status. In order for me to complete the creation of this customer, I need to fill out a salesperson code and I need to fill out a phone number. What I'd like to show you at this point though is if a user tries to unblock the customer, I get a warning stating that the phone number needs to be completed. The other restriction that is in place at the moment is the workflow restriction. So if I decided to send an approval request, the system tells me that there are field security warnings that need to be resolved before the approval request can be granted. In order to bypass that issue, I'm going to add in a phone number as well. I now no longer have warnings up at the top of the page, and the user now has the ability to change the block status of that customer, provided they have permission to do so. It is also worthwhile noting at this point that standard Business Central does flag certain fields as being required. It does not enforce a mandatory restriction in the same way as Field Security Plus does. So this is basically a suggestion to the user that that field needs to be completed. It is not part of the Field Security Plus application. So now that those fields have been completed and I have removed the block status, I can send for approval request. And because I am the approval admin, it has automatically approved this customer for me.